Thank you, Alicia. Thank you, Olivia. Good morning and welcome to Shoreline United Methodist Church. COVID-19 lockdown is almost over. We thank God for His healing grace and thank all of you for your patience and faithful support. Let us worship God together who called us to be his children and the messengers of the good news of Jesus Christ for the world. Let us pray. God, protector of the widow, the orphans and stranger, in a world where many know despair, you raised your Son Jesus to give hope for humanity and renewal to the earth. Good and faithful God, while we are sheltering at home, you kept all of us safe and well, and brought us together to join in with this online worship service. Lord, you are omnipotent God, that your Spirit is everywhere. You are in the sanctuary, in the living rooms, bedrooms, kitchens, and next to the hospital bed. Lord, as we take a part in the worship through video or audio, renew our spirit and clean and strengthen our hearts and minds and bodies so we can continue to serve your purposes in this community. God of all creation, continue to strengthen and unify your church in its struggles against the forces of division and mistrust, where hatreds take place against brothers and sisters in Christ, to lead us astray from the purpose that you've called us into. In Christ, we are reconciled, and so we ask for your uniting spirit to help us to overcome all our divisions that we may live in peace. This we pray in the name of the risen Lord, in the power of his Spirit. Amen.
And now, our opening song of praise, Who You Say I Am by Hillsong, is going to be led by Paul and Thomas Lee today.
You are for me, not against me. I am who you
Thank you, Paul and Thomas. And now, our gospel reading this morning comes from John chapter 17, verses 6 to 19. I have revealed you to those whom you gave me out of the world. They were yours. You gave them to me, and they have obeyed your word. Now they know that everything you have given me comes from you. For I gave them the words you gave me, and they accepted them. They knew with certainty that I came from you, and they believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I am not praying for the world, but for those you have given me, for they are yours. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine. And glory has come to me through them. I will remain in the world no longer, but they are still in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them by the power of your word, the name you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one. While I was with them, I protected them and kept them safe. By that name you gave me, none has been lost except for the one doomed to destruction, so that the scripture would be fulfilled. I am coming to you now, but I say these things while I am still in the world, so that they may have the full measure of my joy within them. I have given them your word, and the world has hated them, for they are not of the world any more than I am the world. My prayer is not that you take them out of the world, but that you protect them from the evil one. They are not of the world, even as I am not of it. Sanctify them by the truth, your truth. As you sent me into the world, I have sent them into the world. For them I sanctify myself, that they too may be truly sanctified. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Amen. Thank you, Alicia. From John chapter 17, verse 6 to 19, the title of the message for this morning is Finding Meaning in Life Through Faith in Christ Jesus, of course. In our gospel lesson for this morning, we find Jesus praying a very important prayer. And in this prayer, Jesus prays for himself, he prays for his disciples, and he prays for all believers. After this prayer, Jesus is going straight out to be betrayed. Then would come the trial and the cross. Jesus wasn't going to speak to his disciples again until after he was resurrected. Early on in this prayer, Jesus gives a summary of his ministries on the earth. He says to God, I have revealed you. Which means that through Jesus, we are able to see what God is like. Remember in John chapter 14, verse 9, where Jesus proclaims, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. So in Jesus Christ, we see the character and the heart of God. Amen. And what a tremendous difference this makes in the lives of those who believe. Because this word can be extremely scary, angry, and mean, with or without the pandemic. As most of us know, nearly 100,000 lives are lost during the last 5 months in the U.S. alone, and more than 300,000 worldwide related to COVID-19 death. Life can appear to be so terribly meaningless and so terribly cruel and non-comforting. What is the point of it on. When in Jesus Christ, this life does have a point. In Jesus Christ, this life does have a meaning. Supreme and glorious meaning. Amen. Because in Jesus Christ, it has been revealed to us that God, who is in control of all things, the God who is living and active, the God who created us, is love. And He loves us more than we can even begin to imagine. The more we come to know what Jesus is like, the more we come to know what God is like. For Jesus and God are one, according to the Bible. Amen. Jesus is our bridge over those troubled waters. He brings life meaning, happiness, and joy. Now to those of us who have a relationship with God, we already know these things, but we could never have known what God is like if it hasn't been for Jesus coming and telling us and showing us. In Psalm 20, verse 7, the psalmist declares, "Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we trust in the name of the Lord our God." And the name of the Lord our God is Jesus Christ, of course. Amen. In this world, where we are surrounded by materialism, it can become so easy to blindly trust only in what our money can buy. But money runs out, does it not? And the things we can buy with money, these things are not eternal. If we live only for material wealth, if we live only for fleeting pleasures, if we work only for those things which perish in time, we will one day wake up with a terrible hangover and a truly sick feeling that this life is very hollow, devoid of true meaning, real love, and security. If we live our lives trying to keep up with the faster pace of materialism, not only will we never feel that we have truly succeeded, but we will also live lives which are filled with bitterness, envy, anxiety, and desolation. But if we trust in Jesus, we'll find the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. We will know more joy than we could have ever imagined. In the scriptures for this morning, Jesus is praying for His disciples. And disciples are essentially people who have realized that Jesus Christ is God's Son, Son of God. That in Jesus' word, we can hear God's voice. In Jesus' words, we can see God in action. And in Jesus, we have placed our trust and our obedience. Disciples are those who accept Jesus Christ as the master of their lives. And this is something that has been destined for all of us. In His prayer, according to John 17, verse 6, Jesus prayed to God the Father, "I have revealed you to those whom you gave me out of the world." In God's plan, the disciples were destined for discipleship. But that doesn't mean that God destined some people to be disciples and some to refuse to be disciples. God has His plan, His dream, and His destiny for each and every one of us. And it is our tremendous responsibility to either accept it or reject it. Destiny. What is destiny, by the way? Destiny is what we meant to do. It is not necessarily what we end up doing. Remember that we do have free will. God has great plans for each and every one of us. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. In Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11, plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Are you living into the plans that God has for you? Are you living into the good and loving plans that God has for you, the plans that include a hope and a future? Also in Jesus' prayer, we see he is praying for the disciples and for all those who will believe in Jesus through the disciples' message. Who are those? That is us, everyone in this Shoreline Church family. That's us. Jesus prayed for you and prayed for me. And we must notice that Jesus did not pray for us to be taken out of this world. He prayed that we might find victory in this world, not escape from it. As a Christian disciples, we are not to withdraw from this world and hide out. We are to allow Christ to fill us with the power, the strength, the hope, the motivation to face this life head on and to make a positive difference. And in doing so, we will be living into God's good and glorious plan for our lives. Jesus insists that it is in the rough and tumble of life in this world that we disciples must live out our Christian lives. We are to be the light of the world and the salt of the earth. What a reason to live, amen? What a reason to have a hope and a future. We can, through Christ, make a difference in this often difficult and confusing world. We can make a difference in the lives of others. And in doing so, know that peace and joy and fullness of life that surpasses all understanding and all circumstances. We do not have to allow our happiness to depend on how well the stock market is doing, or whether or not we're living in a fancy house, in an upscale community. We only need to trust in Jesus and live into his plans for our lives. I hope that everyone agrees with that statement. And not two sparrows sold for a penny, Jesus asked us in Matthew chapter 10, verse 29 through 31. Yet not one of them will fall to the ground outside your Father's care. So don't be afraid, Jesus said. You are worth more than many sparrows. Amen. What a reason to rejoice. When the going gets rough, remember this promise of Jesus. You are so precious to God, all of you. He watches over you like a parent watches over a beloved child. You are not alone in this fast-paced, intimidating world. You are worth so much to God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We will not be taken out of this world. But nevertheless, Jesus' desire for all of us is that in Him, we will have a peace despite the troubles of this world, like in this pandemic situation. In this world, you will have trouble. Indeed, we do. But take heart, Jesus comforts us in John chapter 16, verse 33. He said, I have overcome the world. I have overcome the world, Jesus said. Through our relationship with Jesus Christ as his disciples, we are to demonstrate through his victory over this world and our peace in the midst of trouble. Christianity was never meant to withdraw us from life, but to equip us better for it. It does not offer us a release from our problems, but a way to solve them. It does not offer us a life in which troubles are escaped and evaded, but a life in which troubles are faced and conquered. Amen. However much it may be true that, as a Christians, we are not of the world. It remains ever so true that it is within this world that our Christianity must be lived out. We must never desire to abandon this world, but always desire to win it through and for Jesus Christ, our Savior, our God, and our friend. As followers of Jesus, all of us, we are set apart for a special task as we remain in this world. In verse 16 through 18, Jesus is praying for us. They are not of the world, even as I am not of it. Sanctify them by the truth. Your word is truth. As you send me into the world, I will send them into the world. To be sanctified is to be made holy or to be set apart. It means that we have been set apart for a special task. And this is the most important task imaginable. As all of you already know by heart, it is to let others know that they are too loved by God. Amen. That their lives are important and meaningful because God loved them and has a good plan for them. God has set apart for a special task and special life. And when we decide to put our whole trust in Jesus, we can begin to live out that special call. And this comes as we commit our lives to Jesus, deciding to follow him. God doesn't only choose each and every one of us for his special service in this world and set us apart for it. God also equips us with the qualities we need to carry out his will. And by allowing his Holy Spirit to make a home in our hearts and cause us to be born anew, we all begin to process of allowing the Holy Spirit to change us from the inside out. Indeed, equip us to carry out God's plan for our lives. So my brothers and sisters in Shoreline Church community, in closing, as a conclusion, we must always remember that God has chosen us and dedicated us for his special service in this world, in this community. And that special service is that we should love and obey God, should bring others to do the same. And praise God that he has not left us alone to carry out this great task on our own strength. But out of God's grace, he makes us ready for our task if we are willing to place our lives in his hand. So let's place our complete trust, our whole life in the hands of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen? Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, we acknowledge that we often feel incomplete, afraid, and alone. We often feel as if our lives are without meaning. But this is not what we want to feel, for we know that you have great plans for our lives. We repent of those times when we have not trusted you, Lord. Repent of those times when we have tried to live life according to what we think is best. And we fully and completely dedicate our lives to your service. Lord Jesus, enter into our heart and be master of our lives. Increase our faith, increase our hope, and give us the peace and joy which transcends all understanding. Cause us to be purpose-driven Christians, O God, who are totally and completely living for you. And cause us to realize that this is the only way we will be able to live triumph life. In Jesus' name and for his will, we pray. Amen.
We have just a few announcements this morning. First of all, this last Monday, the Stevens family welcomed baby Analia Grace Stevens. And I do apologize if I didn't spell Anias. I mispronounced it. I apologize for that. But we are all excited that we have a new baby as part of our Shoreline family. So, we are separated, but we are enjoying the pictures. And this weekend is a special weekend for many of us. It is Memorial Day weekend. And that means that Monday we are celebrating our veterans and their families who have, through the years, served our country in many trials. And we just want to say that right today we honor all of you and thank you for your service. Our ad council met Thursday night, and so you know our leaders are still taking care of you. Ladies Bible study is this Monday night at 7 o'clock via Zoom. This last Monday we had a great time just socializing, chatting about anything that was important to us. What may have been important to us may not be something important to anybody else, but it sure was fun. But we are going to settle down and we are going to have a Bible study this Monday night. And we are going to use the upper room again. May 13 was the Wednesday. It's trust through prayer. And if we don't need to have a little trust in our prayers at this time, I think it'll be well worth us doing. I have an email that is going out to the general list of ladies, but if I miss you and you wish to do it, send me an email and I will forward you the information for joining the group. And now, as you know, we are not together, but we still have leadership and this church is still hanging on. So we thank all of you for your ties and your faithfulness for the church. And with that, Pastor Lee, will you pray our prayer?
Good and faithful God, we bring our tithe and offerings to you this morning as part of our act of praise. You have filled our cup to overflowing, and we are convicted by the Spirit to share your blessings with our neighbors and with those who are in need. In your grace and love, let us see that your love and blessing will always overflow to reach and bless others. May your people continue to be blessed as we patiently wait at homes to return to normal lives, where we gather together to worship you and spread out to share the good news. Until that day comes, Lord, grant your blessing of health and well-being to your people. In the name of Christ, who will soon come back to take us home. Amen. As a people of faith, we've gathered for worship. As a people of faith, we now return to the world. Go out to share the story of faith, the story of life, with the world around you. As you go out to give a living witness, as you go out to testify to God's love active in the world, know that God goes with you, sharing the laughter and the hope, the fears and the tears. Thanks be to God. Amen.
And now, if you will join us in our closing song, Bind Us Together, as Paul leads us.
Bind us together.
Thank you, everyone.